Next we have, sorry, before Sister Linda comes on, a poetic drama by Sister Marilyn. So please, can you give her a round of applause? It is titled Stripped.
Sorry, this drama is a poetic drama and it's called Stripped. Just let the Holy Spirit have his way. I only knew I was going to do this myself just a couple of days ago. So, and then the song that's going to be added to the end, God just downloaded it to me Thursday night. So let everything be done according to his will, in Jesus' name. The woman you see in front of you was once a child. This fictional story is common, but I'd like you to listen to it for a while. At the age of 13, she was inflicted with pain, abused by her father, who did it again and again. Even though she cried, he would carry it on, for she was a child and he was a strong man. Abuse sexually, mentally, and physically went deep. She kept it all in. At night, she would not sleep. She would cry for help, but no one came. Was it her to blame? As she grew, she started to hate. She hated herself most of all. She saw people as fakes. She saw nothing that made her special. At the age of 14, she would meet guys. Many of them she knew. When they asked her for a date, she would not refuse. By the age of 15, she had slept with many men, so she decided to hide. She ran away from home and got mixed up with people she did not know. She was introduced to crack, speed, and used it to numb the pain. She thought it was great, as she did not have to think. So she lived on it and also turned to drink. Now being 16 and relying on friends, she met Nathaniel. He was a pimp. He treated her special, so she fell in love. But he told her he would only be around if she gave herself to other men. She thought this was easy, no big deal. After all, she was not real. She did this for a year, but started to hate it. Grimy old men laid with her, some of them reminding her of her dad. She started again to feel very, very sad. The drugs and drinks increased, so most of the time she was stoned. One day she found out she was pregnant. It was for Nathaniel, as she would use protection. He told her to abort the child, otherwise how would she survive? She would be no use to him and couldn't be his wife. Babies don't go well with this job, so my sweet get rid. She stood dumbstruck for a while. Because she loved him, she did. After the abortion, she did not feel the same. It felt like something had been taken from her. She was in more pain. Her heart ached and there was a longing too. I could have had my baby to love me for true. She would cry at night and ease the pain by drinking, taking drugs, and going on the game. She was confused. She was lost. She wanted to run away from her past. Where could she go? What was this life? She stopped caring for herself. Nathaniel started to beat her and ask where's her pride. One night she decided she would not go on. She looked for a way out, but there was none. She stared at the speed of crack cocaine and thought, well, if I took a larger dose, that would end my pain. She was about to do exactly that, but all of a sudden, she was stopped. I love you. I love you. I love you, my child. There's hope in me, Jesus. I've been knocking for a while. Startled, she looked up and saw a loving smile, nail pierced and stretched out to her. She dropped the stuff and cried as she felt a warm sensation on her inside. The words she heard rang in her ears. I love you, I love you. She held up her hands and said, help me, Jesus, please, as she slowly bowed to her knees. As this love she had never felt before surrounded her, she knew for sure that her life would now change. So with every strength she had on the inside, worship flowed from her.
No.
Amen. Amen. He knows our name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh,